In this video, we'll start off bonds with a look at some basic bond terms. Then we'll go through a problem to see the basic bond concepts in action, and we'll also learn how to price a bond. Let's get started. What are bonds? Not bands, bonds! They're actually just loans. Rather than getting one big loan from the bank, a borrower gets lots of little loans from people and other companies. In this video series, we'll primarily be focusing on bonds from the viewpoint of the borrower. For bonds, when people and companies lend money to the borrower issues a bond indenture to each lender. The indenture is just a written IOU. Just like for other loans, there are two cash flow streams. First, there's the principal, the amount being borrowed. Note, the principal amount has several different names. It's also called the face amount, the par value, or the maturity value. And this amount gets paid at the end of the bond term. The second cash stream is the interest. For the exam, the interest will likely get paid annually or semi-annually. To compute the interest payment, we multiply the principal amount borrowed by the stated rate. The stated rate is only used to compute the interest payment. Once you've computed the interest payment, throw that stated rate away. You won't need it anymore. Note, the stated interest rate also has a few different names. It can be called the nominal rate or the coupon rate. Now, for bonds longer than 1 year, it's a non-current liability. And just like other non-current liabilities, these bonds get recorded at present value. Note, when we discount to present value, we use the market rate, also known as the effective rate or the yield. Let's see how these concepts work with an example. Start by reading the question. Then, as you go through the prompt, you can keep what you need and throw out what you don't. The question reads, what amount of proceeds on the sale of bonds should Spector report? It's asking for Spector's bond proceeds. Make a note on the top of your board. Let's read the rest of the prompt. On January 1, year 1, Spector issues 800,000 of 10% bonds at par. An important part of the question is organizing the information they give you and anticipating where the question is going. Here, let's start to organize the bond provisions. The face value is 800,000, the stated rate is 10%, and it says that the bonds are issued at par. Make a note, that means that these bonds are issued at face value and there is no discount or premium. Back to the prompt. Interest is payable annually on December 31st. The bonds mature in 5 years. The market rate of interest is 10%, and then they give us certain present value factors. Notice here that the stated rate and the market rate are the same. When that happens, the bonds are issued at par. That confirms the prompt. Sweet! Spector issues the bonds on January 1, year 1. Remember, bonds have two cash streams. The first cash stream is the principal, the amount borrowed. It gets paid back at the end, the maturity date. Here, the principal borrowed is 800,000 and it's for 5 years. That makes these bonds non-current liabilities. And just like other non-current liabilities, these bonds must be recorded at present value. To calculate the present value of 800,000, we multiply 800,000 by the present value factor of $1. We use the $1 factor because it's only paid once at maturity. Let's calculate 800,000 times 0.62092 equals 496,736. The second cash stream is for interest payments. We calculate the interest payment as face times the stated rate. Note, this is the only time we use the stated rate to compute the interest payment. Let's plug in our numbers. Face is just another way to say principal, 800,000. The stated rate is 10%. 800,000 times 10% equals 80,000. The prompt says that the interest is paid annually on December 31st. So we pay 80,000 at the end of each year. By the way, it's the same payment over and over again. What's that called? An annuity. And the annuity is the money we have to pay over 5 years. It's a non-current liability. And non-current liabilities get recorded at present value. We multiply 80,000 by the present value factor of an ordinary annuity. An ordinary annuity just means that the annuity is paid at the end of the period as opposed to the beginning. And for interest, it makes sense to pay it at the end of the period. Interest only occurs with the passage of time. At the beginning of the period, no time has passed. Let's calculate. 80,000 times 3.79079 equals 303,263. Now we add these together. 303,263 plus 496,736. Equals 800,000. Okay, it really equals 799,999, but we're just gonna fudge the last dollar to rounding 800,000. This is what the borrower gets at issuance. How does this get recorded? For bonds, always start with the bond payable. That's going to be the face value, your nice round number. Here, it's $800,000. Bond payable is a liability. The liability, the amount we're borrowing, is increasing. That's a credit. What's the other side of the entry? Cash. When you borrow money, you get cash. That's the amount we computed from our two cash streams. Let's go back to the question. What amount of proceeds on the sale of bonds should Spector report? Proceeds just means money. How much money do we receive? Answer, $800,000. Let's take a step back here and note a few things. When the stated rate equals the market rate, the bonds are issued at par. Looking at our journal entry, we can see that at par means that the bond proceeds equal the bond payable. Now let's just wrap up with the different types of bonds. First, there are term bonds. These bonds have a specified term, meaning length. They mature on one specific date. For Spector, that date was December 31st, year 5. Next, there are debenture bonds. That just means that it's unsecured. There's no specific asset that acts as collateral on this bond. It's similar to credit card debt. If you have a credit card, you probably didn't have to put up any specific collateral to borrow money. So lenders on a debenture bond are just general creditors like the credit card companies. There are also serial bonds. Serial meaning each bond matures one after the other. If you issue 10 bonds on January 1, year 1, then you can have one mature each year for 10 years. One on December 31st, year 10, another on December 31st, year 11, and so on. This makes it easier for the borrower to pay back the bonds. They only have to pay a little each year rather than paying one large amount. And think of the word series like a TV series. There are multiple episodes. Here it's serial. There are multiple maturity dates. Just to summarize, the borrower issues bonds, which is just a written IOU. When pricing the bond at issuance, remember there are two cash streams, principal and interest. The interest gets paid at the end of each period, usually annually or semi-annually. The principal gets paid at the end of the bond at maturity. If the bond is more than 1 year, it's considered non-current and must be present valued. For more practice on pricing bonds, take a look at the additional videos that price bonds with a premium and a discount. Next up, we're going to review the effective interest method. You want to be sure to hit these points on the exam, so don't go away. I'm Liz Cho with Test Prep in a Snap.